coming to you from the stage of the Ambassador Theater.
Oh, you're gonna see a sheep and shimmy and shake.
And all that jazz.
Oh, she's gonna shimmy till the gutter's break.
Oh, and all that jazz.
So,
the cool thing about Chicago that I think we're all very grateful for is that we have a certain amount of improv that's built into our show every night. So where most shows you have a long-running thing, you're doing the exact same thing every night, we have a little reprieve from that because we have actually some leeway in terms of we can bring our own sense of integrity to the material that we perform every night, and that we can actually change it. We can do a completely different show Monday than we did Tuesday. You know, so that I find, I'm so grateful for that because I like to explore, you know, movement, certainly, for my other interests, but I like to try them on and really see. I just think there's nothing more exciting than coming to work and saying, look, I've been doing this scene for 3 years, how can I make a difference tonight, you know? So we actually are blessed to have that, you know, because when you're thinking, oh God, I might need a new job, then you can come to work and recreate your show and it works. So we are famous, Chicago, for having, you know, stunt casting. We have a lot of celebrities coming in and out of the show all the time. And it's amazing how a lot of them have very little onstage experience, but we have like a sort of Chicago boot camp where, you know, our music director and our choreographers and dance captains and stage managers really train, they train them to be in the show, and really, it's amazing to watch their learning curve, you know, like over the course of time. But as understudies, I think we can all agree that there are certain days when you're like, oh my God, let me at it, you know, because you just want to get up there and, you know, and just give it a crack at it, you know. Yeah. But the reality of Broadway and our, you know, whatever, just the economy, is that if you're not like a recognizable television star, you're at least not going to be the star of Chicago. I don't know, because that's our niche.
That's the niche, and that's the trend that's definitely happened in the past 5-10 years. You know, and it's funny that you should mention that very thing, because, you know, in the courtroom scene, every night, like when I'm watching Amos with Roxy, like I feel myself almost like wanna like
jump.
And I'm like, geez, one day it's just gonna fly out your mouth or something. Like I think that every time. So
I think that would be so funny if you just started screaming, I love you.
And like that's the part. Like I'm like every night I'm like, ooh.
Well, and also we sit on stage, so it's in a lot of shows, you know, you go to your dressing room, but when we're not actually dancing, we're sitting in the chairs, you know, we're supposed to be in jail, so we are trapped on the stage, and so there is that sense of like, let me out, you know, whether it's just out of your chair or out of the building, I mean, you know. I play this part, Go to Hell Kitty, and I struggle. I have this like physical altercation with Mama, and I'm supposed to run, and she's supposed to stop me, you know? And a couple times, like, she's missed, and I've often seen, you know, you see yourself, like, outside your body, like, thought, if she doesn't catch me, I'm just going to jump off this stage and run out that door. Keep going. I do love starting the show. I love the opening speech. I think it's really cool. I like the responsibility of setting the tone for the show. I take it really seriously, and I think that, you know, I like to tip my hat to those that came before me. I think that there's a legacy here. And so I'm really proud to be, you know, to represent that kind of thing, and to be sort of the first image that people see. But, you know, I, like, kill 4 people with a machine gun every night, and no matter what happens in your day, like, that can really solve a lot of your problems. So
I'll say this. This is my most difficult. You know, and I don't know if you'll take offense to this, but, you know, I dance Me and My Baby, you know, which is two dancers, the guy who plays Harrison, Michael Cusimano, and me dance with Roxy during Me and My Baby. Now, with every Roxy that comes into the show, there's always a slightly different baby. There's always slightly different choreography. And your brain can go like crazy because it's like, which one is this? And instead of like, I mean, and sometimes they're on for just one performance, so it's like you're on and you're off, so it never quite really sticks. So like the first performance of this particular Roxy is usually just about me remembering the steps. So it's like, that's like, it's like if I were King of Broadway, what would I do? I would set Baby so that there would be no other way of doing it except for that one.
Yeah. If it makes you feel any better, the same is true for Hot Honey and Nowadays. there are completely different versions of those dances. Like, I know about six nowadays. And what do we do nowadays? We stand there with a cane and a hat. Like, but it's those small nuanced things. Like, you know, do you just go change, you know, or is it change, you know, or is it change, no head?
It's gonna change, you know.
Whatever. I mean, there's all these things. And, like, look, you know, you're on once in a blue moon every 3 months. And you're like, and it's all based on whoever was the star, whatever that person did well. I mean, this is a terrible example because it's a very small thing, but Hot Honey, you know, there's a lot of choreography in that. And that gets completely fine-tuned to that person. So it can either be, you know, the authentic, really sort of complicated, nuanced version, or it can be watered down into something that's so simplified that there's hardly any of that nuance left because it's based on what that person's capable of. So, so if it makes you feel any better, like, I feel like when I'm on as an understudy, like, I get all the way to the end of the show and then I have to be like, thinking cap on, you know, when it should be like clear sailing. So we're all together and we sing, come on, babe, why don't we paint the town, ba-da-ba-da, and all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down, ba-da-ba-da, and all that jazz, and that should be our show right there. Whatever you got on that should be so subtle and so simple and so clear as to, first of all, this is the kind of party you're at, right? And also, it should be able to convey, you know, so much emotion and so much intensity, and it's so beautifully staged that the audience knows exactly where to look in that 1 second. And to me, that's the essence of our show right there. And I think you have to be the kind of really confident, put together actor in order to land that moment. That's my favorite part.
It's just something that I just like the line of this for some reason. And I do it on the other side.
It goes both ways.
But you know, but I just like it because I feel like I'm pulled this way and pulled, you know, I'm my body's in a nice line that I like, and that's really basically it. That's what I like.